After months of denial, Beverley has finally accepted the fact that she may lose her house and pets if she doesn't make drastic changes. She has no other choice but to participate in a massive clean-out of her home.
This is her last chance at this. If this doesn't work, like, no one in our family is willing to help again. Like, this is it.
Professional organizer Stacey Walker is overseeing the cleanup along with a crew of haulers. And Constable Horner has returned to help out as well.
I'm very excited. There's five other police officers here with me, and we're gonna tackle this house, and I'm hoping we're gonna get a lot done.
Okay, everybody, thank you for coming. Beverley is gonna be making all the decisions today, but she has given us some rules that we can work with. Anything that looks like trash or is broken, then you can take it to the dumpster. But most of the stuff that's in the front room area, we'd like to take to this pod, and then we'll have a little bit of space for doing some sorting. All right, is everybody ready?
Yeah!
Oh my God, a lot to clean up.
I don't even know where to start in there.
What's that?
There's a binder on the shelf that says things I want to buy. That's a big binder.
We're finding a little bit of everything. It's surprising, and it's starting to smell in here.
Okay, that fridge, I bought it, and that fridge never worked from day one, and I'm sorry, but I'm gonna try to clean it and return it because that was like $100, and I'm not gonna just throw it out.
Oh, good.
Yeah, no, can you smell it?
Hold my eyes of water, yeah.
When I opened that fridge, it hit me hard. The smell went right through my mask and everything. It was bad. I don't think she could have returned that fridge.
Do you get that the store won't take it back?
But it should have worked.
Well, yeah, but you're not going to be able to prove to them now that these guys will take it now in the dumpsters, or it has to go to Equal.
Okay, just throw it.
Okay.
Dog poo, cat poo, rotten fruit. We got everything here. I wouldn't be surprised if there's something dead in here.
Ah! Yeah.
You okay, buddy?
What is that? Something smells. I smell it too.
That's like rotten egg. That's what that smell is.
I stepped on something. It was an egg, I believe, but just the smell that came from it, it was awful.
Okay, yeah, it can go in the pod for now.
Yeah.
Okay, this can go in the pod. Can you stick that in the pod? That stuff can go to, like, the pod for now.
What is in this thing here? Is this pod?
That goes to the pod.
So far, it's going pretty slowly. I mean, people are moving things, but it's all going in the pod.
Most of the stuff that we're keeping is garbage, and it needs to go, but we can't get that through to her, and all we're doing is creating another hoard outside.
Oh, that's dog stuff. I want to keep that. I'm not going to try to hang on to everything. Oh, I'm not throwing that out.
As work continues downstairs, two of the officers move upstairs to see what progress they can make there.
Oh, my God. I am absolutely dumbfounded right now. I'm like blown away. It just shows the level of how ill she really is. I can't imagine anybody doing this to themselves. I honestly don't even think it's safe to be in this house. I really don't. Yeah, we're done.
We're done.
This house needs to be burned down, like demolished.
Wow.
I thought when they said they couldn't clean the upstairs, that was totally ridiculous. They had like suits on and masks and that was completely ridiculous. I'm just gonna do it myself, so it's like no big deal.
As far as I'm concerned, I do not feel comfortable at all. Cleaning upstairs.
Okay.
That needs a special team.
Training. Okay.
Without proper training with dealing with biological, like, that's biohazard. Nice. Upstairs, okay. 100%. I would not feel
absolutely
safe.
Well, we don't want anybody doing anything that puts them at risk. So I think we'll leave upstairs and the basement for today, and we'll just focus our energies on the main floor.
If I could make the decision today to take her out of that home, I would. The animals, I would take those too. Like, it's just not fit for human or animals to live in.
Okay, I've got my magazines here. I'm getting overwhelmed now because there's too many things, too many people coming to me too many ways. I just need to go through this stuff.
As the day quickly comes to a close, it remains unclear whether enough progress has been made to save Beverly's home.
There's a lot of work left to do. The pod is full of things that we're going to be debating over. I would like to get rid of 80%, but I think we'll do really well if we do 50.
We didn't even get to the second floor, to the basement, and the dog feces and mold is still in the house. Her house still is at risk of being condemned.
Four guys to do this.
There's some major things that need to be done to make that house safe.
Beverly's cleanup day ended with very little success. Over the course of the next 6 weeks, she was left to her own devices, responsible for getting the house into a condition suitable for city standards. Today, Constable Curtis Horner has returned to see if her work will meet those guidelines.
My expectations with the house is not that a miracle and it's going to be completely clean, but that it's going to be a safe environment for her to live in, that major things were addressed and that she can start to at least get ahead and on top of the clean. If I'm not happy with what I find in the house, then me and Beverly are going to be having a long talk.
Oh, hi, Curtis.
How are you? How are you doing?
Good, how are you?
Not too bad. Hey, guys. Oh, this looks a lot better. Oh, this is good.
When I first walked in today, I thought that this was definitely what I kind of wanted to see done. I am happy with the progress that Beverly's made in the time period.
Obviously, I still have a lot to do, but at least it's...
You know, the first thing that comes to my head is you have an area here. You have, like, we couldn't walk over here before. You actually have places you can sit down. You got some art up here. It's starting to become looking like an actual person's living room that is personalized, right?
Yeah. Finally feels like home. There's so many things I bought when I moved here, and I never put them up, and it's just amazing. And now, cleaning it up, I now feel like it's a home.
Okay. So what happened here?
Well, a lot of this stuff came from the pod. And so this is still, I'm still working over here. Then I can use the dishwasher now. I have access to the sink.
Okay. I was concerned about the pod because I did believe that we were just going to move one hoard from the pod back into the house, which has kind of happened. But it's being addressed, which is the most important thing. It's just not sitting there. It is actively being tackled. So I definitely want to see the fridge, but just before we go in there, I wanted to let you know that there's not a lot of things that scare me, but this fridge scared all of us when we were here cleaning the place. So I'm excited to see what you've done with that. Well, there you go.
It is clean.
So it's nice to see that the fridge is actually operational and she can stop using outside as the refrigerator. Okay, this is good. I see that you removed a lot of the carpet.
Yeah, I didn't have really a choice. It's damaged.
Okay. I was extremely pleased walking up those stairs and not seeing all the dog feces everywhere. That was the biggest concern, and it's gone, which is fantastic.